Okay? You guys ready? Okay, you guys are ready, right? Okay, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1.
My name's Yako Protis, and I teach the percussion class, which deals with bucket drumming, beatboxing, and hand drumming. The students that I work with in the percussion class are 5th and 6th graders. When you're dealing with music, the main math connection is the counting, because that's the framework of how the beat sounds and how the rhythms sound. You also are dealing with multiplication, because you're counting sections of music. So it deals with multiplication, and then also division, because you're dividing the beats up.
First there's a whole, then there's a half, then there's a 1/4, there's a 1/8, and then there's a 1/16.
Cool. Give a clap. How are math and music connected? Divya.
Math and music is connected because, like, they have like notes, like called like half notes, quarter notes, eighth notes, and whole notes, and all of those like have to do with fractions.
So when we're playing music, how can math help us play our beats or play whatever we're playing better? Evelyn.
It can help us by like using math by dividing it, each beat, so the beat could sound better.
And what other ways?
If you're counting, like you could like, it won't like mess up the tempo.
Okay, so you have to keep the tempo, and you have to keep track of how many times you do things, right?
Yeah.
Okay, and Arshi?
It keeps rhythm, and you kind of understand what you're playing because you stay in order.
Right, so it helps us keep track of things and keep everything in order. That's great. Math is just a natural part of music. So when we talk about it and we think about it, we always talk about math and we use math. Okay, so a whole note lasts for 4 beats. And what's another name for those 4 beats that we use in music? It's another term. Tanya.
A measure.
A measure, okay? And a measure is just another name for those 4 beats, and that's the way that we measure music and we keep track. We keep count of the music. Okay? And so, we already said we have the whole note, we have the half note, and as we continue to divide the beat smaller and smaller, what's our next division?
If the name of the notes that you have in Western music, that style of notation, they're actually named after fractions. So when you write it down, you write it 1/8, that's the 8th note. So that one piece of that is one piece of the 8. You know, that it's really based on the total.
Drumming has helped me in math class by the fractions that we learned. I was never good in fractions, but then taking drumming class helped me because learning about the beats, so that helped me a lot.
This one is a piece that's based off of a reggae beat, right? The one we've been working on. And in this piece, we have 2 groups. We have group 1 over here, which is 2, 4, 6 people, and we have group 2, which is 2, 4, 6 people. So group 1 does a rhythm for 1 measure, okay? Group 2 does a rhythm for 1 measure. You guys repeat that section again, 1 measure each, right? So how many measures is that?
4.
Say again?
4.
4 measures, okay. Group 1 is gonna do an 8-measure beat. Group 2 is gonna do an 8-measure beat.
We do exercises where we figure out what the total amount of measures are, so that we know from start to finish where we're going.
32.
Okay, excellent. So we have 32 measures, okay? And that'll help us keep track because we have all these different sections and we need to know where we are.
And you're dealing with beats that the kids are hearing in their everyday life. You want to approach students on what they are already inspired by. And then from there, you can take them in different places.
1, 2, 3. Thank you. Excellent. Give yourselves a clap.